First to a dramatic twist on the eve of one of the state's most bitter by-elections, with the Liberal Party tonight under investigation for misleading voters.
Kimberly Pratt joins us live from Nord in the seat of Dunstan. Kim, it could lead to tomorrow's result being challenged.
It's extraordinary, Will. As we go to air tonight, the Liberal Party has been issued a please explain. Seven News understand Labor has made several complaints, including about this campaign poster. It claims Labor wants to introduce a GP patient tax. That is wrong. The state government is wanting to recoup payroll tax from GPs, but it is not a tax on patients. The Electoral Commission is tonight trying to contact the operator of a social media account which claims to be linked to the Liberals. If it's found the Electoral Act has been breached and the Liberal candidate, Anna Fenizio, wins tomorrow's election, Labor could lodge a court challenge. Elections have been overturned in the past due to dodgy party leaflets. One thing is for certain for now, this election is going to go down to the wire once again. It's a three-woman race, but tomorrow's Dunstan by-election's more of a midterm test for the men who lead them.
I think they're just focused on really minor little issues.
I think there's too much focus on the hospital ramping, and that's not just a Labor issue. That's been an issue for many years.
Voting Greens 100%.
I'm the new Marshall. That's it.
Well, if I'm honest, boring as I don't think anybody's really interested in it.
It's been 2 years almost to the day since the long-held Liberal seat became the state's most marginal.
Ultimately, it's up to the people of Dunstan. Do they want more of the same on Saturday, or do they want to vote for change?
And today was the last chance for member hopefuls to pitch to voters.
Every day people are talking to me about the state of our health system.
I actually hope that people can ignore the mudslinging and concentrate on the local issues.
The key issues that have been brought up consistently are around cost of living pressures.
Already 8,000 people have made up their minds in postal and pre-poll voting, but for those yet to cast their votes, there'll be 12 polling booths open from 8 a.m. tomorrow. At the general election, the Libs held onto this seat by just 260 votes, and if tomorrow is just as close as analysts predict, we won't have an outcome until at least Monday. A government has not stolen a seat in a by-election for more than 100 years. Kimberly Pratt, 7 News.